Good evening and welcome to River Road Church. We're so glad you've come for tonight's concert. Well, I've had the pleasure of hearing some of this concert already, and I know you're in for a really wonderful treat. So please welcome William Bradley Roberts and Vox Humana. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much for being here. You know, you complete the triangle, because the triangle comprises the composer, the performers, and it's not completed until we have the third part. That's you. Ears to listen. So thank you so much for being here. The work you just heard, Mozart, Misa Brevis in F, Kirchhoff 192, was composed in 1774 in Salzburg. It's a Misa Brevis, meaning a brief mass, and it was designed for use in corporate worship. In Mozart's day, it was not uncommon to have a professional orchestra and chorus every Sunday morning in church. And the royalty and other people who paid for these things expected that kind of showing for music. This is an unusual Misa Brevis in that it has a credo, which we did not do. Ordinarily, Misa Brevis does not have a credo. But in the interest of time, we left the credo out so we could pack in some more music for you tonight. The next thing we're going to do is a motet by Brahms based on Psalm 51. You'll recognize that, those of you who are churchgoers, because it's the passage that begins, "Create in me a clean heart, O God." This is one of my favorite pieces in the world. It's just, I've been doing it since I was 18 years old, and I'm madly in love with this piece. It has three short movements. It was composed by Brahms in 1860. The first movement is a canon between the soprano and bass. The second movement is a chromatic fugue depicting the text, "Cast me not away from your presence." Brahms was great at word pictures. The last movement begins with a canon between the tenors and basses, then a glorious fugue based on the theme of the first movement. Now, if all that is gobbledygook to you, you are welcome just to sit and bathe in the rich, gorgeous sauna bath of Brahms. You don't have to know anything about this piece to enjoy it. It's just gorgeous music. Hope you'll enjoy this motet by Johannes Brahms.
Thank you.
The next section of music we're doing is, oh, there I am, all of a sudden. The next section is music about the earth. And it begins in the early morning with the first piece, and the last piece of the section is all about a star. So we go through an entire day. The first work is by a young American woman of Asian Indian extraction who is a composer in residence for the Los Angeles Master Chorale. Rena Ismail calls on her Indian heritage, basing this piece on Indian ragas, short, melodic, and rhythmic formulas that are repeated throughout. God is Seen is arranged by Alice Parker, a shape note tune from the early American hymnals. The tune has a curious name, Captain Kidd. You're right, that's the pirate who was hanged. This tune is named for Captain Kidd. Actually, it was a hymn tune first, and then in the 19th century, a ballad developed about Captain Kidd, and the name stuck with the hymn tune. So this is based on Captain Kidd. And it was the text was written by an elusive character named Elder Hibbert, who we think was probably a Baptist pastor in New Hampshire in the 1700s. A beautiful text about the glory of God in creation. The piece of Wild Things is by an exciting young composer and based on a poem by Kentucky poet Wendell Berry. The composer, Jake Runestat, is based in Minneapolis and is doing some of the most exciting writing in choral music today. I hope you'll hear this name again if you haven't heard it before. And the last piece is really a classic, Choose Something Like a Star. Many of you probably sang this in school choirs as you were growing up. It's on a wonderful poem by Robert Frost and is by the influential composer Randall Thompson, who was very active in New England during his lifetime and had an effect on music all over this country. So enjoy this section called This Fragile Earth, Our Island Home. Sorry, missing from my folder is the organ piece that's going to be done next by Chris Martin. So please enjoy listening to that.
Thank you. I go and I
spirituals are, by my light, finest folk music ever created on these shores. Born of cruelty and suffering, they look towards a future life in heaven where suffering ceases. First, Ain't That Good News. This is a classic by the arranger William Dawson, who was the choral director at the famed Tuskegee Institute, founded in Alabama by Booker T. Washington in 1881, and had a flourishing choral life at the school. The second thing is the sheer joy of You Can Tell the World, arranged by the venerable Alice Parker, who turns 97 in December. Next, two uncommon spirituals arranged by a highly suspicious composer, who called them uncommon because the tunes are not the ones that we usually associate with these texts, but these are completely different Negro spiritual tunes apart from Nobody Knows, which is the familiar tune, and This a Light of Mine, I'm gonna, that's the more familiar one. Each of these is not the familiar one, but an uncommon spiritual. And last, The Storm is Passing Over by the African-American composer Charles Tindley, arranged by the African-American music educator Barbara Baker, who lives in suburban DC.
Yes, he did.
Heal the sick and raise the dead.
Yes, he did.